Welcome to our review on the halogen displacement reactions. So in our previous video we had a look at the halogens and one of their reactions. Now what we're going to go on to is a second and very important reaction to know about the halogens, which is displacement. So as we said last time, when we're making the salt, then we make something called a metal halide. And quite simply, when we're referring to a halide, it's a compound of a halogen and one other element. And that element is usually metal or hydrogen. Now, in our displacement reaction, what we're actually seeing is that a more reactive halogen is going to displace a less reactive halogen from the halide. So to give you an example, I've got my amazing drawing skills out here. So we start off with chlorine, which is up near the top of the group, which means it is reactive. Then we've got our salt here, our halide of sodium bromide. And bromine comes beneath chlorine, so it's less reactive. So you can see it's got weak little arms there. Now, when we mix chlorine and sodium bromide together, the chlorine is more reactive than the bromine, and therefore it pushes it out of the way and takes its place with the sodium. So we end up making sodium chloride, and poor old bromine is pushed out on its own. Hopefully in class you've carried out this experiment. So you have a spotting tile, and into your spotting tile you're going to put a mixture of two solutions into each of the dimples. So you'll have one row of sodium chloride, and to that you'd add chlorine water to one, bromine water to the next, and iodine solution to the third. Then you'd do the same thing with sodium bromide and potassium iodide. Then when you record your results, you'd end up with something like the table at the top there. So chlorine, when it's in the form of chlorine water, and we've added that to sodium chloride, there's no reaction because we're mixing chlorine and chlorine. We're not going to do anything. If we mix our chlorine water with our sodium bromide, then we see a colour change, and you can see it in the results at the bottom. So that slight colour change tells us that bromine's been pushed out and chlorine has taken its place. And then the third one along, the sodium or potassium iodide, and the chlorine water, we can see there's a very clear colour change in that one, telling us that the iodine has been displaced by the chlorine. And the same you can see in the results for the others, but you'll notice bromine only displaces the iodine, and iodine doesn't displace any of them, because iodine is less reactive than both bromine and chlorine. When we come to write the balanced symbol equation for this, then remember that key fact about our halogens, they are diatomic. They go around as Cl2, Br2, I2, always the little two in the bottom right. They will then react with two molecules of our metal halide to make two molecules of the metal halide and one molecule of our halogen, going around again in diatomic form. This is the one that people throw away the marks on, because if you just write it as Cl plus NaBr, then you're going to make NaCl and Br. You'll think it's balanced. You've got it wrong because your formulas for your halogens are incorrect. So your formulas are wrong, your balancing will be wrong, that two mark question gets you nothing, just because you forgot that halogens are diatomic. So don't make that mistake. And again, the reason that we see this is because chlorine is more reactive than bromine, so it will displace it from the salt. If we were to have been given the sodium chloride reacting with bromine on its own, then we'd see nothing, and it would form the sodium chloride and bromine. So it wouldn't change anything because bromine is less reactive than chlorine, so it wouldn't possibly displace it from the halide. So one thing we can actually use then to model what happens to each reactant is something called a half equation. So this is where we're just going to be looking at one reactant at any given time. So in the example we just looked at of chlorine reacting with sodium bromide, we'd have a look at what happens to the chlorine and what happens to the bromine in two separate half equations. So I've modelled them there for you. Chlorine starts off as Cl2, and we're going to add two electrons to it in order to make the chloride ions, so 2Cl-. Now, because it's gaining electrons, it's a reduction reaction. Think back to oil rig. Oxidation is loss of electrons, reduction is the gain of electrons. if we consider what happens to our bromine, it starts off in its salt, so therefore it's starting off as bromide ions, and there'll be two of them, and they're going to join together to make bromine as a molecule, Br2, and those two electrons are going to be released. So you get Br2 plus 2e-. So because we're losing electrons, it's an oxidation reaction. If we then put that together as an ionic equation, we've got the one at the bottom. Cl2 plus 2Br- makes 2Cl- plus Br2. Because what we're actually doing here is just focusing on those bits that are changing. The sodium is the same on the left and the right, so we can ignore it. There's no difference there. We don't really care about it. So the ionic equation just has the bits that have changed. And because we've got both reduction and oxidation taking place, we refer to this as a redox reaction. And don't worry if you're still a little bit shaky on this, we're going to come back and revisit this idea in the chemistry at various points throughout the course. Hopefully at the end of this video, we can now describe what a displacement reaction is and which halogens are able to displace which other ones based on their reactivity. You should also be able to write a balanced symbol equation for the reaction and the half equations for them.